Welcome to our mock proctoring of the ACT test. In this video, I will walk you through a fully proctored ACT exam. I'm going to cut to the chase in some ways and not read the entire script that you're going to hear on that fateful morning when you take the exam. But in any case, I'll do my best to give you guys the timings of how each section is timed. We'll also give you the timed breaks and offer you verbal warnings as you would hear on an official ACT, assuming that your proctor does everything they're supposed to do. If you're not familiar with our channel, be sure to subscribe because we have lots of free ACT prep tips. We also have an online prep course, the best ACT prep course ever, so check that out too at supertutortv.com. Let's get started. Test one is English. You will have 45 minutes to work on test one. Do not begin work until I tell you to do so. During this time, you are to work only on test one. If you finish before time is called, recheck your work on test one, then place your answer document inside your test booklet and close the cover. Do not turn the page to the next test. You may now break the seal, but do not open the booklet. You have 45 minutes to work on this test. Open your booklet to test one, read the directions carefully, and begin work. You have 5 minutes remaining on this test. Stop, put your pencil down, close your test booklet, and look up at me now. I know I'm just a video, but thanks for watching. It's now time for test two in mathematics. All problems on the mathematics test can be solved without a calculator. However, you are allowed to use a calculator on this test. If you brought a calculator, you may get it out now. You're responsible for knowing if your calculator is permitted. I will check your calculator during the test. Just kidding. I really can't see through your screen, so don't be creeped out, kids. If you use a prohibited calculator, you will be dismissed and your answer document will not be scored. You are also responsible for making sure your calculator is working properly. I will not provide you with backup batteries or a replacement calculator. Surprise! Do not share your calculator with another examinee, though you're probably at home doing this by yourself. You may have only one calculator on your desk or in operation at a time. If you did not bring a backup calculator or yours malfunctions, continue testing. If your calculator has games or other functions, you may not use those functions during the test. You may only use the mathematics functions. Keep your calculator flat on your desk. You will have 60 minutes to work on test two. Do not begin work until I tell you to do so. During this time, you are to work only on test two. If you finish before time is called, recheck your work on test two, then turn your calculator off, then place your answer document inside your test booklet and close the cover. Do not turn the page to the next test and do not work on, fill in, or alter ovals for test one. Please remember to close your calculator quietly in consideration of others. There will be a break after I call time on this test. You have 60 minutes to work on this test. Do any figuring in your test booklet. Turn to test two, read the directions carefully, and begin work. You have 5 minutes remaining on this test. Stop, put your pencil down. Place your answer document inside your test booklet, close the booklet, leave it on your desk, and look up at me now. Put your calculator away. You will not be permitted to use it for the remaining tests. You will have a 10-minute break now. Know that on the day of your exam, your break may be up to 15 minutes long. Testing will resume promptly at 9:55. However, that's just on our fake little clock and probably not the real time, so you really should just check your watch and be back in 10 minutes. If you return late, you will not be allowed to make up lost time. Remember, you may not access phones or other electronic devices during the break. If you do, you will be dismissed. Attention! Please get ready to resume testing. Remember, if you are wearing a watch with an alarm or have any other alarm device, it must be turned off. If you have a cell phone or other electronic device, it must remain powered off and stored out of sight until you are dismissed from all testing for the day. Clear your desk of everything except your pencils, erasers, test booklet, and answer document. Do not open your test booklet. Remove your answer document and check the front page to be sure your name appears in Block A. Test 3 is reading. You'll have 35 minutes to work on Test 3. Don't begin work until I tell you to do so. During this time, you are to work only on Test 3. If you finish before time is called, recheck your work on Test 3, then place your answer document inside your test booklet and close the cover. Do not turn the page to the next test, and do not work on, fill in, or alter ovals for previous tests. Even with the test booklet closed, this behavior is prohibited. You will be dismissed and your answer document will not be scored. You have 35 minutes to work on this test. Turn to Test 3, read the directions carefully, and begin work. You have 5 minutes remaining on this test. Stop, put your pencil down, close your test booklet, and look up at me now. Test 4 is science. You will have 35 minutes to work on test 4. Do not begin work until I tell you to do so. During this time, you are to work only on test 4. If you finish before time is called, recheck your work on test 4, then place your answer document inside your test booklet and close the cover. Do not fill in or alter ovals for any other test. You have 35 minutes to work on this test. Turn to test 4, read the directions carefully, and begin work. You have 5 minutes remaining on this test. Stop. Put your pencil down, close your test booklet, and look up at me now. This concludes the multiple choice portion of the ACT. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't, because we've got lots more tips on the ACT. I've scored perfectly on the test myself. I've coached a student to a perfect score. So I hope that you check out the other things that we have here. We also have an awesome online prep course called the Best ACT Prep Course Ever. We've helped students improve their scores by an average of 5 points and had increases of up to 12 points. So I strongly recommend that you check that out. We even have a free trial, so you can sign up. We won't charge your card. Even if the button says pay now, we won't charge your card for the first 5 days. So if you cancel any time in those 5 days, you won't even be charged. And you can check out some free resources and even free test explanations for the official ACT practice test. So if you just took the free official ACT practice test from 2018 or 2019, we have those tests on our course and they're totally free with our free trial. So I recommend that you guys go check that out. If you want to move on to the writing exam, we're going to be doing that next. And if you're not taking the writing exam, know that on official test day, you'll probably be required to do an extra 20-minute section. That's just a trial section for the ACT to test out new questions on you guys. But that isn't graded, so we're not going to include that in this mock test here. We will continue testing shortly. You may use this time to relax and sharpen your pencils, but you may not leave the room. Let's move on now to the writing test. You will have 40 minutes to work on the writing test. Do not begin work until I tell you to do so. If you finish before I call time, recheck your work on the writing test, close both your test booklet and your answer document, and place them on your desk with page one of the answer document facing up. You must sit quietly until time is called. Are there any questions? You may now break the seal, but do not open the booklet. You have 40 minutes to work on this test. Open your test booklet, read the assignment, and begin work. You have 5 minutes remaining on this test. Stop. Put your pencil down. Close both your test booklet and your answer document and keep them up separate on your desk. Turn your answer document so page one faces up and look at me now. That's it, you guys. You totally just took the ACT in its entirety. Congratulations. We hope you enjoyed this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, comment below, and tell us how you did on your test. Again, we have an online prep course for the ACT, the best ACT prep course ever. We also have YouTube videos. If you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, we've got lots of free tips here too. And I hope your ACT went well. Good luck with your prep, and hopefully I'll see you guys in a video soon. Bye-bye.